All right, hi. So I'm Nick. I'm the new guy here at Climbing Hole Review. So I guess first a little bit about me. I've been climbing now for 10 years. I started climbing in Newmarket, Ontario, which is in the GTA, kind of. About 3 years ago, I moved out east, where all my family's from, back to the Rock. So I'm living here in St. John's, Newfoundland, and loving it. If you haven't been, you gotta try to get out here. So moving on, I'm happy to be here with Climbing Hold Review. I'm happy that they're giving me the opportunity, and so let's get started with our first review. So today we're reviewing these guys. These guys are the Enix Small Pockets number 2. And as you can see, small is a relative term. So this is number 1 on the list. It's actually my favorite guy. If you can see, it's kind of I guess, like, if it was on a vertical, you would call it a full pad, but as you go down in your angle, you're losing more and more. So, like, by the time you have, like, 60 degrees, you're down to, like, half a pad, because this pocket is really slopey as it gets more overhung. So, I mean, I'll give you a quick view there. What it kind of looks like, and that's what you get. I mean, my initial thoughts with these guys, I must say, I didn't I thought they were, standard pockets, good quality. As I went along and played with them more and more on the different angles and stuff, I actually like them more that I play with them, which is awesome, which is, it's a little bit surprising. Check all the boxes. We have set screw pre-drilled right there. This guy's the only guy that's not a hollow back in the whole set. You can see the nice little quality stamp there, taking one from the Euro playbook. Besides that, wonderfully sanded. Oh, almost dropped it. So this is number 2 here. Kind of looks like this. If you notice these guys, one thing we noticed about these pockets was when we first took a look at them, we were like, hey, those look really familiar. And what it was, and I think it was Noodles who first mentioned it, and he said, I reviewed those before, and what he was referring to was the friction pockets, the dome shaped ones. If you haven't seen that review, you should go back and check it out. They're a little bit different though. They're similarly shaped. The dome shaped ones are a little bit smaller. These ones are The dome shaped ones are dual textured and they're a little bit deeper. These guys are kind of really, like, the way that you would set these guys is really different than the dome shaped ones I found, like, or at least the dome shaped ones that I played around with. Because these guys are shallow, so they kind of lend themselves more to, like, being side pulls and compression problems, I suppose. It's great. Fun. So this is the hollow back. Looks great. As you see, nice center column there. Bolt hole, pretty dead center. Nice little stamp there again. One little minor thing I can say about the stamp is, it did run a little bit, so the 8 is like you're barely able to make it out as an 8, but like that's super minor, obviously. Long, third guy, kind of like the last guy. Yeah, this guy's, yeah, it's about a pad. As you go really steep, you know, you're going to lose some of that. It's two fingers. Again, these guys are great. You can, like, especially because you got the shed screw, you can kind of spin them and set them however you want. They're kind of easiest as an undercling on some overhang and stuff, or as a side pull, or you can set them with opposing holds. If you try to pull them straight in them on like something really steep without having the opposing hold for an undercling, it's quite difficult, especially when you get down to like, you know, I guess 60 degrees. It's tough. You can set them in a roof. You have to be super strong though. I could barely actually hold myself in the roof with these guys. So if you really want to challenge like some of your stupid strong climbers, put these guys in a roof. On a sport climb or something, be great. So, again, give you a little view there. So, this is number 4. Fourth guy in set. Two finger pocket for me. Can't quite get three fingers in there for me. So, I mean, big fingered people, you know, it's going to be two pocket for you. Small finger people, you're going to be able to get three in there. Yeah. So, again, like, nice rounded edges. I must say, one of the things that people complimented on this was the texture that people liked. Yeah, they all come with the nice little Enix logo there. You can see it shining in its dual texture. It's not really getting in the way of any pulling or anything like that. I mean, you're mostly just got your hand in there and you're getting your thumb on there, maybe just cause some pressure there to make the hold a little bit better. But besides that, there is a little nick out of this set screw. I don't know if that happened because of us or not. I mean, this time, I guess this review is a little bit different because I'm doing this from the customer's point of view. This is your holds that I bought a while back in October. So that's a little bit different. We might have done that. Normally we would, as soon as we got them, we would do the walkthrough so we'd know what was what damage we could have done with them. Other than that, I can say they all sit nice and flush against the wall. None of those cheating fingers can get in there and grab that edge. It's not gonna happen as long as you got a good wall. Last but not least, this guy is he's the deepest of the bunch. You know, depending on how you set it, you know, it's two or three fingers, depending on how comfy you want to be in there. This guy's like two pads deep, for the most part. I mean, as you go down here, you get a slopey kind of section. Besides that, I mean, this side is going to be bad. It's going to be really bad, and this side's going to be really good. So, yeah, he's probably the easiest of the whole bunch because he's not a sloping dish like the rest of them. Yeah, so that's all for me. Check out the review, and as always, in true climbing hold review fashion, peace. Thanks,
You're supposed to go last.
You can just like play it backwards.
Easy peasy.
Yeah, that's the foot that's in. Besides that, it's just, you know, feet tracking.
So that's cute what you got done. Did you just cut socks off? Keeps your legs warm too when you only got whatchamacallits on.
Yeah, you don't have to go one after another. Just climb like you normally would, right?
It's different when there's a camera pointed at
you. With a bunch of your friends, you know, you're just having a session with your buddies. We might get you to go once more. At the end.
Because you're just going to do it.
Yeah, I know.
Because then I'll probably cut your first one out so that it shows you doing it at the end. Rather than it's like, first guy up, oh, he crushed it.
Nice, come on, Adam. There you go. Yeah, maybe just leave that. Thank you. So if they're sure to be a problem. Right on. Maybe try from the two on the feature, like Sarah's doing. You have to do a very controlled, like... Wow, in pockets, you gotta be controlled. You gotta be controlled in pockets.
Do your fingers give you troubles? Yeah, don't shove that in the pocket. Get in, give it a burn. Give it a burn. Yeah, that's alright. It's the green hold. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Left foot. Yeah, there you go. And then you just push up into it. No. It's all the green holds. It's okay. Fits with our genre. Comical reviews. Yeah, try to go controlled to it.
Controlled?
Yeah.
Like this.
Yeah, yeah. That's usually what destroys your fingers and pockets. I think you'll get it, man. But if your fingers hurt, don't do it. That is something that will destroy fingers. It will get you to go now?
Yeah. Oh, that was tired. Yeah. So you're saying push harder than that?
Anyways, you found something you need to work on. Probably a matter of like lock off or something. And maybe footwork.
I think it's just greasy now.
Could be. Nice, come on, breathe.
Come on.
There you go, come on. Nice.